settle accounts with his slaves. When he began reckoning, one who owed him 10,000 talents was brought to him. And as he could not pay, his lord ordered him to be sold, together with his wife and children and all his possessions, and payment to be made. So the slave fell on his knees. say about how to live well. Full of examples today. Living well perhaps means reconciliation in as much as it is possible. Forgiveness in as much as it is possible. Not carrying a grudge in as much as possible. Living with compassion and patience and endurance and forbearance. Our scripture readings today are full of examples of how to live well. And if we are able to do those things now, while we are among the relatively healthy and still alive, when our time comes, we may better be in a position to die. We may be the type of person who friends and family would want to visit, not out of obligation, but out of love. Something rather significant to strive for, I think. You know how to live well, Dr. Dugdale says, you may be well prepared to die. Dying heartily, she says, and I learned this some time ago when I was a hospice chaplain. Dying heartily enables a person to say with sincerity and deep affection and feeling five particular words and phrases that I hope are on my lips when it is my time to go. I pray that they will be on yours when it is your time. Those five things are, I forgive you. Please forgive me. Thank you. I love you. Goodbye. That is the art of dying. May we be so blessed, be word and sacrament, to learn well and practice the art of living. Amen.
Amen. Day he rose again.
holiness and bring you to everlasting life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to Him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
You may be seated. Good morning and welcome to St. Paul's in person or wherever you are watching from on this live stream. As we prepare the altar for Holy Communion this morning, know that you are welcome to receive the body of Christ as we are blessed to share it from the altar here at St. Paul's. If you are worshiping from home, you may participate in spiritual communion. That means when it is time to receive as the body of Christ gathered here today.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen. gives the